Hey, hello everybody, how are you all doing today? Hope everybody here is doing amazing. Hey Adventure, hey Warren, hey Reed, how is everybody doing? Harris, SB Hunter, Mr. Potato the First, Smash, Anthony, Noah, Trash Panda, Catfish, Tyler, Morris, Hunting Nonstop, how's everybody doing? Hey Dundee, hey Jace, hey Noah, hey Atomic Acid, hey Hunter 17. Hope everybody has been doing absolutely amazingly today. We're going to be jumping into it shortly. I'm just finishing something up real quickly. Hey, Daisky, how's it going? Hopefully I said your name right as well. Hey, Tyler. Hey, Flair, Texas Pickle, Pineapple, John. How's everybody doing? Hey, Kim. Hey, AZ Fishing Machine. Hey, King Duff. Hey, Blue Lee. Midway Games, MP Fishing. All right, let's jump into it. Let's get into the hunting. Hopefully you've all been doing great. Hey, Zach, how's it going, man? I don't even know what loadout I got on. Was I grinding bears? I can't remember. I think so. Yeah, I think bears was the last thing I hunted. I never know if I left off on Revon Thule or if I left off on the Great One grind. It's been pretty decent hunting nonstop. We've had 15 diamonds over the course of the grind, but unfortunately we have not had a great one. So hopefully today will be the day we get that. Hey, Brobra. Hey, Caitlin. This the Sweden map? No, Brobra. This is not the Sweden map. Can confirm, not Sweden. Just blast that turkey real quick. Since there's no male bears here. Just got a 450.50 diamond caribou. That's awesome, Ben. That's a big one, man. That is a massive caribou. Great one in 3 days where I use all my money on 223 ammo. Oof. You just might be buying 223 ammo then. Because I don't know if this thing's ever going to show up. It's been a tough grind so far. I gotta say, this is the most difficult grind I've ever done. This thing is just absurdly difficult. There we go. Finish that turkey off as well. Hey, Blitz, how's it going, man? Glad you could make it to watch me suffer through the grind. Yeah, Morris, we've seen it. I use all my cash on 300. Recommend using 243 because it's free. That is a good tip. If it's for a species that can be used, that the 243 can be used on, then yeah. It's definitely a good way to go if you want to save money. I believe both of them died up here. Yep, they did indeed. Couple turkeys to start out the day of bear grinding. I'm going to try and do quite a bit of grinding today. So I don't know if we'll play any Revon Thule. We'll see though. We might get to Revon Thule later in the stream, but to start off, we're going to do quite a bit of Great One grinding. Gotta start pushing hard towards getting that thing. Hey Riley, how's it going? No bear here. Well, I guess it's another turkey that we will be taking down. Started whitetail grind, 1500 kills, 2 mellow, 1 albino, 2 piebald, probably 7 diamonds, and 3 trolls. Not too bad, Brandon. That's not too bad. Nice, Blitz. No, Dylan, you didn't miss anything. We honestly haven't been live that long. Hey, Gavin, how's it going? Yeah, Is the Red Deer Guide still good since the update? Unfortunately, no. Unfortunately, it's not quite as up-to-date as it was. I think really the only thing different is the left side doesn't have as many lakes that have red deer now. They've kind of switched them around. The river no longer has them. The small lakes in the bottom left don't have them as well. All the lakes that I showed on the right side of the map, though, they still have red deer. So I'd say the guide's like 70% accurate now since they made the changes. But it's definitely not fully accurate. I hope so, Dylan. I hope so, man. This grind has been a very, very grueling grind. I mean, at first we were trying to kill, like, 200 to 300 bears a day. And after a while, I was just like, man, if I keep this up, 200 to 300 bears a day, like 7 to 10 hours of grinding, I'm gonna go crazy. But I've toned it down a little bit. Probably only doing like 100 to 150 a day now. Nice, Bluey. Nice. Yeah, hopefully, Punisher. Hopefully, man. Got a level 2 Diamond Capricali today. Nice. That's awesome. That's awesome, B-Man. Is it easier to get a Red Deer Great One? I'd say yes. Black bear are very difficult in general. So, yeah, red deer is definitely easier. I think it's probably the easiest great one to get. Nice, Hunter. What map is this? This map is Silver Ridge Peaks. It's a really nice map. Easily a top 3 map for me. How rare is an albino pronghorn? Very rare. You don't see those too often. Seven to nine. Nine to 11. Well, the bears are just absent today. They've decided that they don't want to show up, which is unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate. Where did that turkey go? Well, I guess we're not going to be taking him down. Or the other one. I don't know where either of them went. No, Hunter. You don't have to kill diamonds to get great ones. There have been many cases of initial spawn great ones, and you know, you wouldn't have had a chance to have killed anything in those cases, so you definitely don't have to kill a diamond to get a great one. Quite a few people have got theirs without even shooting anything. Wow, the bears are very absent today. That's wild. I mean, they could just be in different lakes. Most likely that's what's happening. Hey, Mystic, how's it going? Oh! Oh my gosh, hi! Hey! What a start to the day! Oh my gosh! Another level 9! So this is our 17th legendary of the grind. Alright, we're gonna do a test, guys. Because we had issues with the 308 hitting too far to the right, we're gonna see if it does it on a stationary target. I have to know, you know? I gotta know. Let's see. Oh, don't do that to me. Don't you dare take a step forward. There we go. That looked good. That looked really good. Yep, he's going down. We got him. We got him. Oh my gosh. What a way to start the day. The first bear we see is a legendary. Oh my gosh. We have been on fire recently. Just legendary bears everywhere. Love to see it. Love to see it, man. Yeah, it's definitely been very strange, Kaylin. I have had some really weird stuff happening with the 308 at long range. It looks like it actually worked out this time, though. It looks like this shot actually did hit decent. Which is... it's definitely good. Definitely a good thing that it hit good. I mean, yes, Scarecrow. It's definitely good that it's good. My gosh. definitely. If it was a Fabled, I would, I'd be screaming a little bit more. Definitely would be a little more excited, Hunter 17. Here we go. Is this the first diamond of the day? Yes, it is. 2320. Let's go. 2320 diamond black bear. Yes, tall boy. I have indeed had my coffee. That's a decent bear. Like, that's not bad at all. 0.40 above diamond. Good way to start the day. Nothing better than starting off with a diamond. So what you're going to want to do, Taft, is actually get a couple different perks and skills that'll help you out with it. I'll show you real quickly. There's a few of them right here in the rifle perks. A steady hands you'll definitely want to get because it decreases the wobble. Breath control is great because when you hold your breath, you'll have decreased wobble. Your shot will be much more steady. And then muscle memory helps with like readying your shot up quicker. If you go to the shotguns, you'll definitely want to go for recoil management. This is one of the most important perks when it comes to accurate follow-up shots because it reduces the recoil like crazy. Hey, Hollow, how's it going? Hey, Johnny, you guys just missed a diamond number one of the day. We bagged a diamond already. First bear we spotted. Zach, thank you so much for becoming a member. Really appreciate it. Guys, oh my gosh, we're at 180 members? When did that happen? I think at the end of yesterday's stream, we were at like 175 or something. That's insane. Thank you guys so much. But welcome to the Scarecrow, Zach. Enjoy the green name and chat, special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access to private Discord channels once you link Discord to YouTube, and access to my scrap content on the channel. Really appreciate it, man. That is insane. I wonder if we can make it to 200 members before the end of the month. That would be crazy if we could. Oh, you saw the harvest screen? Nice, Johnny. What's my favorite map to hunt? Tiabaroa, probably. Tiabaroa and Revontuli Coast are very close. And then Silver Ridge Peaks used to be my favorite, but with this recent update, Tiabaroa and Revontuli have taken over that number one spot. So SRP is now number three. Still a very, very good map, though. Nice, Brock. Go for it, man. Hey, Lisa, how's it going? You missed a diamond black bear. We've got one diamond on the day. This guy needs to go down. How many animals can you shoot before it deletes the zone without a tripod stand? I believe 15, and then the 16th one will delete it. If I'm not mistaken, I believe that's how it is, at least. Could be wrong, though. Definitely could be a little bit wrong there. But I think that should be accurate. Yeah, definitely catfish. I think it will be. I think we'll get an Australia map and an Africa map sometime soon. I hope, at least. All I gotta say is the December map, it's gotta be a big one. Because Way of the Hunter will be out. Ultimate Hunting is supposed to release around the same time. So, they've gotta have something big up their sleeves. They gotta have a big release ready for December. And what better map to do it on than Africa 2.0 or Australia? I feel like it would be a no-brainer to introduce one of those maps right when your competitors are coming out with their games. So I kind of hope they do. I hope they go for it. Oh gosh, you guys are talking about ice cream now? Oh man. Now I'm going to be craving ice cream the whole stream. Of course, Karma. I mean, you've been in all the streams recently. Of course I remember you. Yeah, Pac-Man, definitely, man. Lots of good options there. Amazon jungle map? A jungle map in general would be pretty cool. I'd like to see a Australian jungle, like a rainforest. Similar to Pick-A-Bean Bay in the Hunter Classic. Yeah, Blitz, at this point, I think they have to do either that or Australia. I think regardless of which one it is, people will be happy. Because it's been the two top most requested ones for ages. So I think no matter which one gets done, Africa or Australia, I think people will be happy. I definitely will be. Hey, Swords, how's it going? Want to see something desert? But we've already got, we've already got Mexico. We got Rancho Del Arroyo. Alright, let's alert them. See if we can spook any big males out of the grass. You are definitely not that. That is definitely not it either. I think this is the four. No, that's a female. That's the four. Okay, definitely... nothing worth shooting here from what I can tell. Yeah, nothing worth shooting here. Argentina map with doves would be so fun. That would be cool, Logan. I would like to see doves in the game at some point. Doves would be very awesome. Yeah, Dylan, hopefully we get it, man. It really depends on the Australia map to me, Blitz. I want to see something similar to Pick-A-Bean Bay in Classic, where we get Sambar and Roosadeer. I want to have Sambar, Roosa, Axis all on the same map. And then also stuff like the Bantang, Magpie Geese, you know, similar to Pick-A-Bean from Classic. That's what I want to see. I'm not really much into the kangaroo hunting and stuff, like, they just don't do anything for me at all. An England map with pigeon. But you can only hunt the pigeons with knives. Hopefully, Blakester. I really hope so. I mean, we started out with a diamond, so that's it's a good start. Hopefully we can keep that up. What map would I recommend to get first? Ooh, that's a tough one. I'd say Revontuli Coast, probably. Revontuli Coast has a lot of species that you can hunt early on. And a lot of them give quite a bit of cash. There's always something to hunt there. I'd say it's a pretty good option. Excuse me, ma'am? You just chilling here alone? Yeah, but it's hard to say if they would even have lions, Blitz. They might go a different route with it. It's hard to say. Considering people always complain when they repeat a lot of species, it's hard to say what they would even put on it. What would I think of them adding spears? I wouldn't mind it. I think it could be a cool alternative to the current hunting methods. Would definitely make for some interesting hunts. Hey, Captain, how's it going? Nice, Snipes. That's awesome, man. That's the one that I want. I want to get the Fabled Glacier. What is the best skill and perk? I mean, that is like impossible to, that's like impossible to even answer. Because there's a lot of them that are very useful. You can't really single out a perk that's better than the other perks. Because like a lot of them require other perks to make them good. There's no way they'll add a 50 cal, Mr. Potato. There's no way they would add a 50 cal. Because it's really not used for hunting. There's a couple people that use 50 BMG for hunting, but it's not common. Most of the time, if you're going to go for a larger round, you'll go for one of the African big game rifles. Like the 460, the 416, the 470, like 375. That's much more common to see than a 50 cal. There's no way they'll add one. Got a 7 and a 4. Do I see any more? Level 6. Level 6. Level 4. Level 5. Okay, we got a few we can shoot here. What's my favorite animal in real life? I'd say cats probably are. I've always liked cats more than anything else, but when it comes to hunting, I'd say red deer. Got a 4 there. Okay, we'll take down the 7 and the 6 first. Anything else worth taking down? No. We definitely don't have all our bears here. The rest of them will probably get here on the second run through. What's the maximum number of tents that you can have in Quattro Colinas? It's the same across all maps, and it's 16 tents. You can have 16 tents on every map. As an April Fool's event, they should add a laser gun to make all the animals pink on a selected map. That'd be interesting. That'd be very interesting. To be honest, if they ever did an April Fool's thing, I would say they would probably just tell us that there's a Great One Jackalope on the map, and then everybody would search for it, but there actually wouldn't be. That seems like the type of April Fool's they would do. I mean, in Classic, they added T-Rexes for a day, or a couple days, but you couldn't claim them. They would eat up a ton of your ammo, and then you'd go to claim it, and you couldn't. So, I got a feeling that if they did an April Fool's in Call of the Wild, it would be like, there's a new great one, go find it, and there actually wouldn't be a great one. Would be kind of funny, though. What map should I do my Great One Whitetail grind on? Definitely Rancho, I'd say. Revontuli is a good option as well, though. So it really comes down to what map you prefer out of those two. I think those were the only three shooters here, yeah. We'll check these lakes. Been a bit since I've been there. So how's everybody's grinds been going? That's a 4. There was a 5 here as well. But as far as I know, there's nothing else, so we're gonna go to the other lake. I do racks, but to be fair, Flinter doesn't really grind for them all the time. He typically tries to get one of them, and then after that, if he gets another, then he gets another. Whereas I tend to just go out and specifically search for great ones all the time. So I don't really compare myself to other creators when it comes to how much I have of something, because everybody plays like at their own pace. Everybody plays differently, not everybody grinds them all the time. So I don't even think it's really a fair comparison to compare great one count with another creator. Are quail in the same spots? I have no idea, Khan. I have not hunted them in months. Arctic map with polar bears? That could be interesting. Nice, Blakester. Nice, Claydrew. Yeah, I don't blame you. I have stopped keeping an exact count and I just kind of estimate now. Because after a while it does get tiresome trying to keep count. How many rares have I got so far? Two on this grind. Out of the like 1750 kills, we've had like two rares. Which honestly is not very good odds, like... we have not got a lot of rares. However, we have got 17 legendaries and 16 of them made diamonds, so... it's been a solid grind. Oh, you're definitely not Blitz, it's just luck of the draw. It is just luck of the draw. Is that the end of the day? A lot of Call of the Wild is up to chance. It's a dice roll every time you smoke an animal. Could come back as anything. Just gotta get lucky. There's definitely things you can do to kinda improve the amount of good stuff you get. Like, I've definitely noticed that since I started using Jaxie Bear's old herd management techniques, I have had an absurd amount of diamonds. I believe I went 10 runs and got 8 diamonds in those 10 runs. It was almost a legendary every single run. And I was only killing like 7 to 15 males per run, but was still getting a diamond every single run. But then you take a look at people like Ron McTube, Kill Clinton, Mel, they've been using the exact same strategy, but have barely been getting any legendaries. So I think that partially just goes to show that it is a luck of the draw sometimes. There is a lot of times where you're not only like doing like a specific method, but then you also have to worry about the randomness of Call of the Wild. That almost looked mellow for a second, but then I looked at it again and it's not. Alright then. Kane, thank you so much for the super chat, dude. Really appreciate it. Anything today? Nothing yet. Actually, I take that back. We did get a diamond. I'm so used to not getting anything early that it's just like the default for me to say that. But yes, we did get a diamond as our first bear of the day. Alright, let's head back here. Hopefully we get it before then, Logan. I'd like to get it today. If possible. Yeah, Rax, I do. Yeah, I remember that, Blitz. With the red deer. Yeah, that's kind of how it's been with Black Bear for me. No great one, though. Approaching 2,000 kills, we're like 250 off, and no great one in sight. Quite unfortunate. Oh, definitely, Rex. The AR pack is probably the best weapon pack in the entire game. It's so good. It is so, so good. Definitely recommend it. Yeah, Saints, I remember you. Nice blitz. I had that happen with Red Deer a while back as well. Red Deer are one of the few species where I've seen that happen. Although, a couple days ago I did have 3 diamond turkeys on my map at once. Just from blasting random turkeys during this grind. Not sure, Lopez. I don't play console, so... not familiar with the controls for it. Speaking of turkey... you, sir, are now a smoked turkey. Ooh, that's unfortunate, Hunter's Life. That would be cool, Johnny. That would be a good map. To be honest, I don't really care, Catfish. Like, if the game's good, that's all that matters. I do catch and release for the most part in real life, so it's nothing different from what I do anyway. In real life, when it comes to like trout fishing and bass fishing and stuff like that, I always release them, unless it's just like so absurdly massive. And then when it comes to like salmon and steelhead, those are the ones that I keep. But if it's like a trout, I pretty much always release it. That's primarily just because I want to keep the trout populations good in the areas that I enjoy fishing. Considering a lot of the places that I enjoy fishing, it's for wild cutthroat trout. And their populations haven't been as good in the recent years. So for me, it's really species specific when it comes to whether I keep it or release it. Yeah, I don't know, Con. I mean, it could be possible. Considering there's no true max score for any of the Truax species, it's always possible that could be a thing. It could have also just been a great one, Red Deer, because they score around there. Some of them do, at least. It's a level 2. He moved right as I shot. Yeah, get that bear. Well, that guy is going to be far away. Probably not even worth chasing after, to be honest. Man, we are just not hitting these good today. Yeah, exactly, Smash, exactly. That's how I do it as well. I release any of the wild trout I catch and then keep the, keep stuff that's stocked or stuff that is just incredibly abundant. Okay, we randomly have a couple small male black bear here. I mean, that's not going to help us at all, but at least they're there. Oh, wow, Blitz, that's a wild dream. That's wild. Oh, nice, Hollow. You'll have to go do it. You'll have to give it a try. Oh, a mythical. That's probably the respawn from that 9. Holy bears. Well, I found where all of our bears have gone. I found where all of the female bears went. Oh, he stopped. No, stop stopping. Oh, man. You know, they didn't used to do that. They didn't used to stutter stop all the time whenever you'd spook them. But nowadays they do. I think it's been like 2 or 3 updates where they do that, but It never used to be a thing. Curious why they suddenly started doing it. They used to just run in a straight line. I've never had either of them, Benjamin. I've heard they're good, though. I think my favorite fish that I've ever had is, greenling. Greenling and copper rockfish have been a couple of my favorites. But I tend to prefer ocean fish for sure when it comes to... when it comes to, like, fish to eat. Saltwater fish are the way to go. But that's greatly a personal preference thing. Yeah, Jet, we got a diamond bear. And then we just got a mythical one as well. Favorite fish is bass? I've never tried bass, outdoor gamer. Oregon doesn't have as much bass fishing as a lot of places, so... most of the fish that I've had have been, cold water fish or saltwater fish. Oh, I just stuttered hardcore. I don't even know if that hit good. Dude, this guy is just stopping and starting. That works. I'll take it. Now, where's the rest? Because there's more than one male here almost every time. Oh, there is the mountain lion. Couple of them, actually. Yeah, we'll take out one of them on the way since we have to walk around there anyway. Imagine the level 4 bears respawn as level 10. That would be something else, Mr. Potato. That would be wild. I'm hoping this method will spawn us something, though. How do you tax things you've saved? From your lodge. You'll want to go into the lodge and then go into the trophy manager in the main menu. Or I guess the pause menu. Oh. Since when have we had a male on that side? Alright then. That's nice. Just a random male over there. No, I've never got to try, paddlefish, unfortunately. What editing software do I use? I use Filmora 11. It's very good. Why do I use the 308 instead of the 300? The fire rate. I value having quick follow-up shots more than I do the extra power of the 300. So having two 308s to me is more valuable. If you can hit vitals, then there's not too much of a difference in kill time. And so I'd rather have 10 shots at my disposal than 8 shots that are much slower. So I opt to go with two 308s instead of two 300s. What level were the animals that respawned as great ones? No clue. It's almost impossible to tell which ones actually came back as a great one. Because a lot of times whenever you're grinding and you shoot a bunch of animals, they don't all get their respawns at the same zone you shot them at. They kind of shuffle around. Like, for example, let's say you shoot 3 females at this lake that I'm currently at. And then I were to shoot 3 males down at this lake. The males could end up here and the females could end up down here when they respawn. So it's kind of difficult to even know which one respawned as a great one. Am I out of 308 ammo? Or what? No? Oh, you were answering a question. Gotcha. Yeah, the 308 would need the 308 ammo, Karma. It's in the name. Yeah, it's a tough grind, Isaac. Very tough grind. Another four. Okay, I don't actually think there's gonna be anything here, so we'll just go to this one. What's my dream catch? Like, for real life fishing? I have always wanted to get a 2-foot cutthroat trout. That's something I've always wanted to get. A cutthroat trout that's at least 24 inches long. It's very rare. At least for a wild cutthroat. Around here in Oregon. I'd love to get a 24-inch cutthroat trout. Because I only know a few people that have ever even seen one. And I think the state record was like 27 inches long. So they're not easy to come by. But when you do come by one, it's essentially one of those situations where you might mistake it for something like a steelhead. I don't really specify what area, Lamian, but the farthest I'll ever specify is the western half of Oregon. Which is the more like, more forest covered, more like rainy half. And then the eastern half of Oregon is like primarily desert. Lots of desert over on that side. What time do Red Deer drink on Tay now? They drink at 6:30. 6:30 to 10:30. Jake North, thank you for the super chat, dude. Really appreciate it. Thank you so much for the support. Hope you've been having a great day. I don't think there's any more shooters around here. Pretty sure it was just that 7. It looked like the others were pretty small. So I think we should be good once we find him. Where is he, though? Imagine he floated over there. That'd be unfortunate. Me too, Ben. Me too. You know, I've fished for a few different trout species, different salmon species, steelhead, some saltwater fish as well, but trout have always been the most fun to me. Ultralight tackle, trout fishing is a blast. I absolutely love it. I doubt it, Noah, but it's hard to say. Nice, Ben. Because they're not a high enough weight estimate, outdoor gamer, we're using the herd management strategy at the moment. Hey, Peaches, how's it going? Because we clear hunting pressure as we're hunting, and a lot of times we're grinding like 10 hours a day, Gavin. I spend roughly 10 hours a day grinding the Great One Black Bear. Well, 7 to 10. It's not 10 every single day. But I clear hunting pressure as I go. So, like, if I don't see bears at a lake I'm at, I'll shoot, like, 3 or 4 turkeys. Or, you know, something similar. And that's a good way to kind of clear the hunting pressure. And also, use tripods as much as you can. If you use tripods, you'll pretty much never have a hunting pressure issue. Yeah, Bob, hopefully soon, man. Hopefully soon. This grind has been grueling. It's been such a difficult grind. I believe those were the only two. Actually, is that another one? Yeah, it is. Okay, perfect. Not bad. I'll take it. 3 decent males. Well, I'm on PC, Jet, so that's probably the main difference. Got a cinnamon diamond black bear. That is awesome, Colton. That would be a super rare, man. That's crazy. That would be a super rare. Yeah, true, Ben. That's another thing. Spending a lot of time hunting a species definitely makes it easier to get a lot of them down. Because you just kind of memorize the locations they're at. Do you shoot all level of males? No. I only shoot the heavyweight 5s and above. So any 5 that is 165 to 227 kgs, and then anything above that as well. And then if I get to a point where I can't find anything in that range, then I'll do a purge of all the lower level ones to get some higher levels to spawn, and then I'll go back to shooting only the high levels. I think it's time for a time reset, though. Hopefully, Zero Savage. Hopefully, man. I like to go like an hour after their drink time starts, because I feel like for some reason they get there quicker when I do that, but it's hard to say. Oh, I've heard about that, Luke. I, to be honest, don't even know what you could do to get past that. I feel like a lot of the older missions, they haven't really taken into account whenever they do updates to change the redistribution of the animals and stuff. I feel like they don't take into account the way that some of the missions are, and the fact that some missions require them in certain areas. Oh, wow, Midway. I did not know that. Well, that's a lot of female bears. That's a lot of female bears. All right, then. Not really anything we can do here, then. Unless there's a couple turkeys to blast. Oh, there's a mule deer. Let's take that down. Maybe eventually we'll get a crazy mule deer trophy. Hey, Grizz, we got a diamond as our first bear of the day. Not sure, Savage. Not sure. When it comes to, like, one-off issues like that where, like, you have a crash after doing one thing in a mission and then you can't do it after, I really have no way that I could even, like, begin to imagine what you could do to fix that. Because that's not something that happens too commonly. Are level 5 female bears a thing? I don't think so. I've never seen one, at least. But then again, I don't shoot the female bears, so I've only seen whatever's on my map currently. Hey, Colton, you haven't missed too much besides one diamond when we started the stream. No great ones, though. No rares. We're shooting heavyweight fives and above midway. So any level five that has the 165 to 227 kg weight estimate, and then anything level 6, 7, 8, and 9, all those are getting smoked. And then anything that's a low weight estimate 5 or below gets to live. It's been working pretty good so far, so we've just been doing that strategy. Yeah, I can't see anything, so we might have to jump down and look around the trees a little bit. Oh, I saw something. Something popped up for a second. But where? It was probably a turkey. But it could be a bear. Hey, Ranald, you missed a diamond black bear. It was the first bear that we saw today, actually. Other than that, there hasn't been anything else too crazy. Nice, Chris. Gotta love those throwing knife diamonds. Yeah, nothing over here from what I can tell. Maybe I was just seeing something. Maybe I walked over a track or something like that, saw the flash in front of my screen, and thought that it was a spotting thing. Hard to say. I'd say probably red deer, Savage. I think red deer is the most enjoyable great one grind. And the red deer looks really good, too. Had a zone with a lot of whitetail bucks, and now they're gone. Will they come back? If they're gone, they probably moved to a different area, Bradley. If you notice any situations where you have a zone or a herd or a few deer go missing, they probably moved to a different part of the map. 9 times out of 10, that's what happened. This lake has just not had any big males recently. Unfortunately. I guess we'll see what the respawn of that mythical is. I don't like it, Jet. I don't like it at all. The way I've always kind of seen it is, if you didn't work for it yourself, then it's not as rewarding, you know? I mean, people can do it, you know, it's whatever, but it's not something that I particularly like. Out of my entire time playing Call of the Wild, I've only ever accepted like one handout, you know? It wasn't even trading though, it was just somebody wanted me to shoot a deer on their map, so I went over and shot it. But in general, I don't really like doing that because there's no sense of accomplishment. And in most cases, the sense of accomplishment is what makes it fun to get those trophies. And if you didn't grind for it yourself, then what type of enjoyment can you really get out of it? There's no massive relief after finally finding it after a long grind. There's no excitement and adrenaline when you spot it for the first time. 9 times out of 10, just not really something that I could ever see being exciting in any way. Definitely not, Savage. I refuse to grind black bear on any of the maps that forces me to hunt at night. Wow. 834 kills into the black bear grind. Nice, Ranald. Loving the ducks on Rev, especially how good the golden eye pay. Yeah, Waffleo, they're great, man. I love the new waterfowl. It's a very good system. That's probably on your end, Flip. I would recommend refreshing the stream. Hey, Jerry, how's it going? I've never played Open Country, kid. I have never played Open Country. And I never will because that game was a massive cash grab. Massive ripoff. They released the game in an incredibly buggy state. It didn't look anything like what the trailers had depicted it. And they have not fixed any of the issues. From what I've been told, at least. So I'll never be playing Open Country. You'll definitely see some Way of the Hunter content here on the channel, though. And that game releases in just a little bit over a month, so very, very soon. It's hard to say, Jet. I'm probably going to spend most of the time today on Silver Ridge Peaks Great One grinding because I really want to get this thing as soon as I can. So I'm going to try and put as much time into grinding as possible. Well, that's not the problem, Kid Hunt. The thing is, like, they advertised it as one thing, and the game was nothing like what they had advertised. It's got very bare bones mechanics. There's not really a lot of progression. There's not a lot of stuff to work towards. There's a massive amount of glitchiness and bugginess. The game was just not what they had made it out to be. And so I'm not going to, not going to get into it. It's just not a, it doesn't look like an enjoyable game to me. Hey Mark, it's been pretty good. We got a diamond as our first kill of the day. We've had a couple nice mythicals show up. It's been a solid day of hunting. We haven't found a ton of males, but the ones we have found have been good. What do you think is next for Call of the Wild series? I don't know. Are you talking about, like, next game? Like, after the Angler? It's hard to say. Maybe Call of the Wild the Survivalist? Nice, Cornet, that's awesome. Congratulations on those trophies. No, Hunter, they have not announced when it's coming out. Once I know, you guys will know as well. Is there an EW website I can complain to about the mission? Anytime you have an issue with a bug or feedback, Luke, go to their support page and write a support ticket. That is the best way to get stuff directly to the developers. Another mythical. Love to see it. Lots of mythicals showing up. But create a support ticket. Just type in the Hunter Call of the Wild support into Google. And it will bring you right to the support page. It should be the first option. That is the number one way to get information to the developers. Content creators don't have as much ability to, like, send it straight to the devs as you would think. Support tickets are the way to go. It's the only method that goes directly to the devs. So it's always important to submit tickets anytime you have an issue in game. Because with the support tickets, even if you don't get a reply back or even if they're not able to help you, it's at least going straight to them and they know what the issue is. Or they can better help find what the issue is. And then if they get a lot of support tickets talking about the same thing, then they know it's a major bug that needs to be fixed. You know, that type of stuff is very vital to future updates and being able to patch things, so always use the support whenever you guys have a problem. And then if you don't know how to submit a support ticket, you can always ask in their Discord. I'm sure one of the moderators or one of the other people in there would be able to explain it pretty easily. Okay, so none of those are big enough. We typically have 4 to 5 here, though, so I'm assuming there's 2 that are very late to their zone. So we'll just head over here. I think it's kind of cool, Catfish. They've already stated that we're not allowed to shoot them, though, so I think that's a good way to do it. They're in the game, but we can't actually shoot them. Yeah, Hunting Legend, that's definitely a very uncommon thing to see. I've only seen one this entire grind. Just found a level 7 blonde male. That's awesome, Brock. I have yet to see a blonde on this grind. Yeah, if it gets deleted the first time, Potato, it's probably a good idea not to just spam the same message. If it got deleted once, it was probably for good reason. Hello, Random Turkey. You like chilling with the black bears? Nice little heavyweight 7 there. How long do I normally stream? 2 to 3 hours typically. However, that does vary from day to day. Sometimes I'll go longer, sometimes it'll be slightly shorter. Recently, the streams have been about 2.5 to 3 hours long, though. Come on. Slow down, buddy. Or, yeah, just go straight at me. That works too. That at least makes it easy. Random Turkey? How you doing? Alright then. I guess I'll take that. That one gets to live. Boop. All right then. Just another random turkey. Love to see it. What's the best rare in the game? That would greatly be up to personal preference, I'd say. Not everybody's gonna think the same things about what is gonna be the best rare. My personal favorite is the Melanistic Pheasant, but I'm sure there's a lot of people that like something else better. Fenix Roleplay, thank you so much for the 16 months as a member. Really appreciate it. Welcome back to the Scarecrew. Hope you've been doing great. Because, Henning, we're using the herd management strategy. We only shoot high weight estimate 5s and above. Would I rather have a super rare or a great one? Depends on the species. If we're hunting red deer, I'd rather have a super rare. Because I really want a diamond melanistic. But if we're hunting something like black bear, I'd much rather have the great one. What's a high weight black bear? A high weight level 5 would not be this one. See, this is 102 to 165. That's the low weight estimate for them. But if I see a 5 that says 165 to 227, then I'll take it out. Because that's close enough to the weight that a level 6 would be. Or I guess it's the same weight estimate as what a level 6 would be. So that's when we start taking them out. Also, where's the last bear? I know we have a turkey here, but there should be one more bear. Did we get them all? Actually, I think we got all three of them. Yeah, it's rough, John Doe. That's rough. You gotta be a little more specific than that, Clay. Like, tips for what on Revontuli? It really, like, the tips that I'm gonna give will greatly vary depending on, like, what you're wanting to hunt for. Okay, let's go. Let's check down here. It's been a bit since we've checked this area. Hey, Glett, how's it going? Yeah, definitely similar, Savage. They definitely do look similar. Random bison over there? Okay. Interesting. I can't say I've seen a bison over there before. That's new. No, Mac, you cannot get a melanistic lion. How to get the 300? You get it through Yukon. So once you purchase the Yukon map, then you get access to the 300. I think it's just one male here. I think it's just one male. Honestly, like, this coastline has not been very good for me. Not really seen much here at all. Hello? Random elk? Hey, Knightley, how's it going? Oh, definitely, Brayden. That would be a cool game concept. I've always wanted them to do, like, a second shot at a dinosaur game. I mean, I guess they did Second Extinction, but it's not the same as, like, the Hunter Primal style game, you know? What does resetting skills or perks do? It just gives you all the points back so that you can redistribute them however you want. I'll be right back, guys. I gotta real quickly take a quick restroom break and then I will be back to the stream. All right, guys, we're back. We are back. Hopefully there'll be some nice black bear over here. I know, Mason, we have not found the great one. Guys, do you really think that I would fall for that? I've had that done every time I've gone AFK during a great one grind. You guys, you can't get me with that. I have had that said in chat at least 50 times when I've gone AFK during a great one grind. All the female bears move to this side. That's interesting. They are typically over here, but they're over there now. Real interesting. And also, there's no males down here. Where could all of our males gone? We're definitely missing a few. Maybe we got them back here? The chat who called, great. Yep. Indeed. Yeah, that'd be awesome, Dominic. That'd be an awesome, great one. Blacktail, mule deer. Sika deer, fallow deer. I'd love all those. Roosevelt elk, Rocky elk, like, those would be some awesome, great ones. Kind of hoping we get an elk next. Not gonna lie, Roosevelt elk, great one would be pretty sweet. What's the mouse that I currently use? I use a Corsair, I believe, Night Sword RGB. Piebald T-Rex just ran by. Oh my gosh. A piebald T-Rex? No way. I mean, we're going to have to go back and get that at some point. That'll go very nicely on one of our waterfowl mounts. Can level 4 Rocky Elk make diamond? Oh, that. Oh, the message disappeared halfway through reading it. This map is Silver Ridge Peaks, Thomas. Silver Ridge Peaks. It's got a spirit brown bear. Nice, Gavin. That's awesome, man. Congratulations. They're really cool. I like the spirit brown bear quite a bit. Probably one of the nicer fur type for the brown bear. How to get rid of hunting pressure while doing the black bear grind? I just shoot random stuff along the way. Like, a lot of the times, if it's on my way, I will blast a couple turkeys or a mountain lion or two. That definitely helps with the hunting pressure. Like, for example, one of these lakes that we're about to go to typically has some mule deer or turkey around it. I'll just blast a few turkeys typically. Turkeys are great hunting pressure clearers. Albino great one pigeon. Oof. Gotta have that trophy. Gotta get that big male for sure. And nothing here. This lake has been so empty for me. Like, I haven't had a male there in so long. I'm wondering if the lake south of that one has anything at it now. They might have moved over there. We also should have one male here. Unless it just hasn't come back here, or maybe it respawned at a different lake. Yeah, I think we need to go check this lake down here. We definitely need to go check that one. Because it seems like they've definitely moved around a little bit. So let's go check down here. How often do they release a new great one? It really depends. It took them like a year to get the second great one added. And then it's been like, I think, 6 months since the last one. So it really depends. Oh. Wait a second. That's a max weight estimate. If But there's definitely nothing here. Is he on this side? Oh, I swear if he's on this side, that's unfortunate. Though, he looped around. Maybe he's down there? I guess we'll find out. Roughly like 160 minimalism. But it can vary. Just got my first Great One Cockroach. Nice, Aiden. Yeah, that's a female. I'm assuming this guy's gonna be like a level 7. I definitely hear him though. Is there just random black bear everywhere? Oh. That's him. Nice, mythical. Okay, we've been getting a lot of mythical and legendary black bear recently. Maybe the great one's close. I mean, after what's probably 1775 black bear kills with no great one, I hope he's close. I really hope he's close. I know Mel is probably at like 21 or 2200 black bear kills now without finding one. It's been such a difficult grind. Herd management, young buckets. I would definitely recommend going to Jaxie Beard's channel and watching some of his videos talking about herd management. Because that's where I learned it from. It might have been a YouTube stream, actually. I think he had a YouTube stream a couple years ago where he talked about it. It was when the Great One Whitetail first came out. He had talked about doing herd management. It's been a thing for quite a while. If I'm not mistaken, I think Flinter and Jaxie Beard started it as kind of like a theory. And they kept doing it for a while. Flinter eventually abandoned the idea. And Jaxie Beard continued experimenting with it. And eventually he found some ways that work pretty good. And so that's why we're only shooting level or high weight 5s and above. And then if it gets to the point where we don't see anything, then we'll start purging all the low levels. Typically, I have to do a low level purge every 10 runs or so, but recently I haven't had to, which is nice. Recently, we've had much better luck with getting good respawns, and I haven't had to resort to purging the low levels. Nice, potato. Nice. Hey, NBS Games, how's it going, man? No worries. You know, life comes first. I appreciate you being able to make the streams whenever you can, but it's not a requirement, you know? Nice, Drew. What's max score for Black Bear? 24. And then I believe the Great One can go clear up to like 28 or something crazy like that. The Great One Black Bear has like ridiculous weight and score. But for just your normal diamonds, the maximum weight or maximum score would be 24 with a max weight of 290. Nice, Blitz. Yeah, Jaxie's always like swore by the herd management technique. That's how he got his great one for Whitetail, if I'm not mistaken. Every time I've tried it, I've had good luck as well. Like, I did it when the Great One first came out after watching him talk about it. Ooh, vertebrae. And I ended up getting the largest whitetail buck I've ever seen in my entire life that wasn't a great one. Scoring 291. They obviously can't reach that score anymore for the most part, unless you were to get incredibly lucky with tip-to-tip spread. But back then, they could get there on rare occasions and I got lucky enough to get one. And then a few months ago, we tried it with Red Deer, and it worked just as good. I was getting diamonds left and right. What's the best map in my opinion? In my opinion, Tiabaroa is the best map. After this update and the changes they made to it, it is easily the best map. There is so many animals everywhere. The map was made pretty amazing this update. Sadly no, KC. Sadly no. We did get a diamond as the first thing that we spotted today. And we've had, like, two mythicals every run. It's the method, man. The methods are working very good. Level 7. Not bad. But yeah, back to the best maps. I think Tiaroa is number one because not only is it a map that has a lot of species you can hunt early on, but it also is the best red deer map. It's the only map with Sika deer and feral goats. It's the best fallow deer map, even with the changes. And overall, it's just a gorgeous map. But the thing that really makes it shine is the absurd amount of red deer and Sika deer during the drink times now. It is just truly a wonder to see the amount of them that there is. How was that not vitals? What? Call of the Wild. Really? Okay. And then I'd say that second best map is Revan Tuli Coast, because it's got a very wide variety of species. It's by far the most unique map. It's got non-stop action, tons of birds, tons of small game. It's a very solid whitetail map, and it's the best moose map. And then number 3 is Silver Ridge Peaks, because it's got a very solid lineup of species. The map itself, once again, has non-stop action. There's always something to do. And a lot of the species on it are very enjoyable ones to hunt. They give good money. It's a map where beginners can easily get into it because a lot of the species can be shot with the starting guns. Not to mention now you have the Great One Black Bear to grind on here. What time is Sika Deer drink time? I believe they start at 10:30 now. If I am not mistaken, I believe 10:30 is their starting time. How is this bear not dead? I mean, I know we didn't hit vitals, but we hit you twice with a 308. How is it not dead? What is this, Cape Buffalo? Yeah, you gotta get Gen 0 now, KC. Everybody's got it but you. You gotta get it, and then we gotta do like a crazy Gen 0 stream or something. Trying to get Red Deer Great One. Nice, Jackson. Hopefully you get it. Yeah, Bree's been having that issue as well, Johnny. She's been crashing quite a bit on Tiaroa. I haven't crashed when I was playing it, so I don't know. It's strange. 2080 is actually, that's pretty large for a 7. That's a good 7 there. Very good 7. Yeah, that would be nice, Leonardo. That would be nice. I'd like to get rid of a bunch of the soft point ammo that I have. Oh, definitely, Thomas. I'm very excited for Way of the Hunter. Very excited for it. Is a piebald fallow deer rare? Yes, that would be rare. Do it, KC, do it. Yeah, Gen 0 is relatively affordable, I've noticed. I think it's because they've had a ton of sales in the past. But it's a very, very fun game. It's almost like hunting on Hirschfelden, but you're hunting for robots, and it also kind of looks like Rev on Thule Coast, but it's got the same snow system as Yukon, and there's rocket launchers and Barrett 50 cals. It's a good time. Would you guys be down to watch a stream of that sometime? Some Generation Zero? It's another game made by Expansive Worlds, so it's got a lot of the stuff that we see here in Call of the Wild, except you're fighting against machines that have taken over the island. And it's got a lot of cool stuff. A lot of base building. There's also like boss robots. It's cool. And there's a lot of familiarities in the game when it comes to like assets and stuff like that. Like you'll see some of the same guns that Call of the Wild has. It's pretty cool. Maybe for a 5-hour special 55k stream? Maybe, Johnny. Maybe. It is the one time that you guys will see a 50 BMG in an Expansive Worlds game, so I think that alone is pretty exciting. Who doesn't like exploding robots with 50 cals? That seems like a lot of you would be down with that. Oh yeah, Austin, it's a great game. It's very fun. And it's got a lot of improvements recently. They've added a lot to the game. I didn't realize like how much they had improved it until I jumped back on it recently, and the game is like a completely different game from when it first came out. What's the longest I've streamed? I streamed for about 12 hours at one point. That's the longest I've done, though. Any longer than that, and I just don't even have a voice anymore. Is albino more rare than piebald? Yes, in most cases it is. Obviously, it's species-specific, but most of the species, it's more rare to get an albino than a piebald. Yeah, definitely, KC, definitely. I used to go for longer as well, like, but nowadays I just can't. I just can't do it anymore. Like, I can go for 6 hours, but 12 is just too much now. Of course, I guess part of that's the whole being a dad thing. Makes it really difficult to do 12 hours since most of the time I only get like 5 hours of sleep. The dog is great, Twinkle. The thing about the dogs, though, is you do have to level them up for them to be useful. So it's one of those things where when you first get the dogs, it might seem like it's not really doing anything. But you have to level it up a little bit, and then the dogs become very good at tracking. There's many times regularly where my dog finds a track that I didn't even see and just immediately beelines it to the animal. It's kind of crazy how good a high-level tracking dog is in this game. But the low-level ones, they're a little bit hard to get past. You definitely gotta put some time into leveling them up. Oh, definitely, Brobra. Definitely. Yeah, Young Buckets, that'd be interesting. I mean, technically, any bolt-action rifle with a scope on it could be a sniper. I mean, oh, nice, another mythical. Even a semi-automatic rifle with a scope could be a sniper. I mean, the AR-308 could be a sniper. I guess it really depends on what you consider a sniper rifle. Because, I mean, Remington 700, that's a rifle that is a hunting rifle. It's also something that can be used as a sniper. How do you level them? Just by making them track stuff. No clue, Catfish. No clue. Thank you, Buckets. Appreciate it, man. Unbelievable, all these mythicals. Oh my gosh, Caitlin. What's my favorite Great One Black Bear fur type? I like the Glacier, the one that kind of looks like the ghost mask. Like, the one that looks like it's wearing a Call of Duty ghost mask. That one is awesome looking. And then I also like the Fabled Spirit quite a bit. Fabled Chestnut's probably my third favorite. What days do I normally stream? Well, right now I'm streaming every single day at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. And as of now, I don't know when that'll change. I think we'll continue doing this schedule. I used to stream every day except for Wednesday and Saturday, but recently I've been streaming on those days as well, so hard to say what we'll end up doing in the long run, but I have liked these more consistent streams. And I feel like moving it to earlier in the morning has actually helped with making it more possible for me to stream every day. I'm not a fan of it, Scott, because there's literally no work done to get it in that way. And it diminishes the value of them as a whole. The more of those that get taken down and the more of them that float around the community, the more difficult it is to believe people when they say that they grinded it themselves. Because there's no grind if you do it that way. There's no grind at all. And great ones are supposed to be something that's rare. And that you have to put in work to get. And if you get it in that way, there's no work. And therefore, in my opinion, they hold no value. Just shot a Dusky Diamond. Nice, Brandon. That is awesome. 2140, that's a solid one. That's a big mythical. Very large male. How many kills do I think it's going to take to get the great one? Oh gosh, considering Red Deer took me 3,088, I'm going to say at least 3,000. I hope not, though. I hope it's not 3,000. My hope is that we'll get it within the next, like, 300, but knowing my history with Great Ones, it's probably going to take me at least another 1,200 kills. Nice, Maddie. That seems like you're having some pretty decent luck. Oh no, Hollow. Yeah, I've heard that the heat's pretty bad over there right now. That's unfortunate. That's very unfortunate. What has happened to all the bears here? Like, I feel like they're just arriving way later than normal, but at the same time, I can't confirm that either. There's only been like 2 to 5 bears here the last few runs. So strange. Maybe I need to start smoking some at other lakes, but I don't even know like where the rest of them would be. Yeah, there's only 2 bears here. OIM Zero Savages, that's the gun that I've been committed to using for about 6 months now. About 6 months ago, I promised I would take the next great one with the 6.5, and I'm going to do it with the Red Raptor sight as well. I already did that earlier, Filled. I did reset the map. Or not reset the map, but reset the game. Went to the main menu. Jumped back in. Still not having any show up at this lake. I'm curious if they've kind of spread out to neighboring lakes or if they're just really late. It could be either. They're probably just really late. That's been the problem the last couple times this happened. I guess we shall see. I mean, regardless, we're still getting a lot of mythicals and sevens, so I guess as long as a lot of those are going down, it doesn't matter if we have a bunch of bears here. We're still getting lots of big males down. Maybe there's some at this lake, though. Guess it's possible. Nice, VR. That's awesome, man. Glad that you like the content. Hey, Levi, how's it going? All my males went to the massive lake in the right center. Don't know which one it is. Called the one without an outpost close. Okay, so this one? I'm assuming you're talking about this one. I checked that yesterday and had nothing but females, but maybe I've got males there now. I'll have to go look at it. Nice, Lisa. Level 99 cockroach great one albino at Balmont Lake. Holy. You might be right. Guess we gotta take it down. Teleporting black bear. Wonderful. Yeah, these are all female. All female at that lake. There's none at this lake. Yeah, I guess we'll check this one. It's been decent, Levi. We've killed lots of mythicals, and the first bear we spotted today was a diamond. So it started out really good. Sadly, our bears have just moved around, it seems. Either that or they're very delayed. They're either very delayed or they've moved. But like, at the same time, I don't see a lot of bears here either. Unfortunate predicament we got ourselves in. The bears have gone on vacation without us. Can we maybe see any in here? That's a female again. Yeah, I don't think they're here. I was hoping they would be, but I mean, unless this is them right here. Could be. That's bison. Bison again. Yes, this is all bison here. That's a bear zone. It's a male. Okay, so we do have a male here. That's a female, though. It might just be one male. I mean, at least that's one male we didn't have before. Very interesting. They really do, Levi. These bears move more than any species I've ever hunted in Call of the Wild. Like, it's kind of crazy how often these things move zones. I swear every run is different with the bears. Literally every run is different. Is it possible to get out on that island? I think I've heard somebody say that it is, but I don't know how it's done. This bear is definitely a weight estimate we need to take down as well, so if we can get him to show up, that'd be great. Should pop into render any second now, I imagine. Female bear tracks. Little pronghorn. There he is. How's it going, buddy? We've been looking far and wide for you. Yeah, Kim, we only had two there this time, which was very strange. Gotcha, Blitz. I thought there was a ATV trick you could use. I'm pretty sure some people had said that you can, like, race the ATV out there, and sometimes it'll, like, bounce you to it. Because I remember I went on a couple servers where there was a tent out there. And it wasn't a cheated server, either. It was just a normal server, and there was a tent out there. And I'm pretty sure the person had said that they, like, rode the ATV until it, like, jumped them off of their ATV onto it. You know, like, when you crash and it launches you. I think that's how they were able to do it. They launched themselves with the ATV. Yeah, CJ, I do. I haven't been able to for a while, though. Level 7 bear. Beautiful. Love to see it. I haven't checked these lakes recently. Maybe I should probably check those. Yeah, that's what I thought, Tallboy. South of Tabagotchi Outpost? I don't even know which outpost that is. I'm gonna have to look at all of them. Yes, I hunt these lakes all the time. These lakes are ones that I hunt quite a bit. I don't have a lot there, but I have, between the three lakes, 2 to 3 males. One of the lakes is all females, though. Well, that was only for that one stream, Tall Socks. I had said that if we found it during that stream, I would do it, but we didn't find it. They're doing pretty good, Savage. What's my favorite color? Green. Which I'm sure you guys probably could guess by the amount of green I use in my thumbnails and logo and stuff like that. Yes, Hunter. Memberships are a paid feature. What gun do I suggest for the Red Deer? Great one. I would say the 308 is probably the best option. M1 is pretty good as well, and if you want to kind of speed up the grind and don't mind messing up the normal Red Deer, you can use the 300 as well to get them down quicker. But you won't get full score for using the 300. But I've used it quite a bit as a way to get them to die quicker. Can I spot you, please? What? There's a level 6 here? What? I've never had a male here this entire grind until now. Oh my gosh. How long have you been here? Well, he's dead now, but how long has that bear been here? That is the first male I've had here the entire grind. That's crazy. Hey, Tien, you missed one diamond black bear. That's been it so far. Got a leucistic and albino bison in the same herd. That is awesome, Catfish. Going to get the Phantasma. Hope I don't mess it up. Nice, Kevin. Nice. I'm pretty sure I messed that one up. If I'm not mistaken, I think I messed that up when I first did the mission. Because back then, I didn't know what to expect. Quattro just came out, and I, like, saw a wolf walk at me, and I just blasted it. Headshot it. Completely ruined it. Yeah, see, and it's been really good. Been really good. Every stream, we've had at least one diamond. When I first started using this method, I was getting a diamond every run for, like, the first 4 runs. Then I went to run without a diamond, then I got another 2 diamonds, 2 runs in a row. Then I went 2 runs without a diamond, and then I got 2 diamonds in 3 runs on stream. Yesterday we got 2 diamonds in like 4 runs, I think. And today, the first run of the day gave us a diamond. So it's been very, very good. However, between another male. That, what? Another male. So they have just moved down here then. That's quite unfortunate for me. I mean, good thing there's an outpost right next to it. What is it, though? Oh, it's a heavyweight 5. We need that. So they definitely have just spread out a little bit. Nice, Warren. Nice, Gavin. Hey, Kyla, how's it going? How you been doing? Thank you, Catfish. I appreciate that, dude. I'm glad you enjoy. Hopefully we will, Scott. Hopefully we'll get it soon. Been grinding musk deer more than black bear? I've heard the musk deer are insane now. I saw that screenshot that you posted of like the absurd amount of hunting pressure on that one spot on the river. That's crazy. That is like absolutely insane. It makes me want to go to Medved and hunt some musk deer, but I don't want to take time away from the grind. I'm just happy they gave Medved the rework it needed. I've heard a lot of good things about it. Seems a lot of people are very happy with the changes. I haven't really got a chance to check it out myself, though. Oh, definitely seeing. Definitely. Maybe I'll do that for one of the upcoming videos. Because I haven't checked my Medved since the update, so I've got an entirely fresh population to look at. That could be a fun video, rediscovering Medved. And I could title it something like, "Is Medved good after the update? Everything you need to know." We shall see. Black muck are a nightmare to hunt now? Oh, that's not good. That's not good at all. Black buck already didn't get hunted too much, so if they made them more difficult to hunt now, that's unfortunate. And probably not the best decision. Although, to be fair, maybe that's why they made them have a nighttime drink zone. Maybe because they were not a popular thing to hunt. Or not a nighttime drink zone. I don't even know their drink time, but maybe that's why they made them more difficult, because nobody hunted them in the first place. Like, I really liked the, black buck, but nobody ever really hunted them. Oh, do they drink at night? 19 to 21? That's a weird time, Johnny. That's only 2 hours. Wow. I was just completely guessing that they would drink at night. I didn't actually think they did. Oh, gosh. The only explanation I can think of is that it was because people didn't really hunt them. That's wild. That's insane. Nighttime black buck hunting. No thanks. Definitely not going to be doing that. I wonder when they'll stop giving animals nighttime drink zones, because I feel like there's not really anybody that likes nighttime hunting. At least very few and far between. .20-36. Okay, the bears should be leaving. Gonna get a quick look over here, see if we can spot a male or two. Should be at least one male down here. Yep, that's a new one. Okay, that's not even the mail that's typically here. That's a new one. There's typically one over here. I think I see him. There's a female. Another female. Can't spot that guy. Another female bear. Come on. Let us spot it. It's a female. Okay. So, did the male just swap sides and the females are over there now? I guess maybe. Either way, that's unfortunate. Oh, well. I guess there's not really anything at this lake. What is the rarest animal in Call of the Wild? I don't know. It's hard to say because they made a lot of changes this update. I mean, I'd say a rare great one would be the most difficult to find. A rare great one whitetail. Okay. Why do I always do that, guys? I went to change the time and then I didn't change the time. I swear, I do that all too often. There she is, everybody. Say hello to Mrs. Crow in the chat. I hope the great one soon. This grind is getting ridiculous. I hope it's soon. Because right now it's not looking great. It's not looking great. We're getting lots of diamonds, but just no great ones spawning. Should probably go to the main menu as well. How about an albino great one whitetail grind next? No, probably not. I plan to do red deer next. Maybe a little bit of whitetail mixed in here and there. Hunting and fishing with Jace, thank you so much for becoming a member. Welcome to the Scarecrow. Enjoy the green name and chat, special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access to private Discord channels once you link Discord to YouTube, and access to my scrapped content. Really appreciate the support. Thank you so, so much. Now, great one. Nope, no great one. Let's go check this lake. It had a couple males last time, so let's see if it still does. There's always been a train on Yukon, Gavin. Yeah, I've played Hunting Sim 2. I am not a fan of it. The game had potential and then the developers just squandered all the potential it had. Nice, Johnny. Any tips for more consistent males in whitetail? I mean, that's not much info to go off of, Tien. Like, what map are you hunting? What's your grinding method? How many lakes are you hunting? I can't really give any tips on how to make it better if I don't even know what you're doing. Because your respawns will greatly depend on the map, how you're hunting, where you're hunting, that type of stuff. Might as well take down a couple turkeys, or hunting pressure clears, as I like to call them. Also, we need to see if that's a male black bear. It looked like it was a male, because the females are typically a little bit lighter colored. So I think that was probably a male bear. It is. And that's one we need to take down, actually. Nice. You don't need to, Muskrat. You don't need to check morning zones because it's the same bears. They just move to different areas. Donald Jewel, thank you for becoming a member as well. Welcome to the Scarecrew. Enjoy the green name in chat, special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access private Discord channels once you link YouTube to Discord, and access to my scrapped content on the channel. Really appreciate it. Thank you so much for being here. What's diamond for pronghorn? 98. What's the method I'm using? First of all, try not to repeat, Brayden. If I don't get to it, then wait a little bit before asking again. Nobody likes to see a bunch of spam of the same message in chat. But we're just killing all high weight estimate 5s and above. That's all there is to it. Alright, later, Blitz. My gosh, Johnny, 20.2. That's insane. That is insane. The whole 6 days game time thing is not a thing, Ryan. That was a myth. There's no need to reset the time more than once. Did the modern weapon pack come with a pistol or no? No, it's three ARs. The 22, 223, and 308 ARs. Killed a troll level 5 mule deer. Ooh, that's unfortunate, Samuel. Unfortunate, dude. Yeah, Blakester, it's insane how much money he has. It's all those mountain lions. He has killed more mountain lions than I think anybody in the community ever has. And because of that, he has got so much money. I mean, more than me. I'm at 10.7 million. But then again, I guess I do use quite a bit of ammo on these grinds. And so I buy quite a bit of ammo. And then I also buy lots of random items for making content, like a million different decoys, and also just taxing random animals for thumbnails. What do you mean, Muskrat? What do you mean by reset spawns? Not quite sure what you're referring to. Need a sniper pack with guns like 5.56, 243 Ackley, and the 222? That could be interesting. I'd like to see a 224 Valkyrie. I've been wanting to see a 224 Valkyrie in game ever since I found out about its existence. It's a pretty cool caliber. It's like a better version of a 223, basically. It's like a 223 with better velocity. It's a cool caliber. Would love to see it get put in game. I have no idea, Tian. I'm going to assume it's probably a YouTube thing. Because it's definitely nothing that I've done. So it's probably YouTube related. When did we get a 5 there? I love how all the bears just kind of congregated on this side after we deleted their zone over here. There's just a bunch of female bears on this side now. And then one random level 5 male. I don't even remember him ever being there. I don't like it, Jivco, and it's also not intended. It's a bug. Alright, nothing that we can shoot here. That's a bug, Atomic. It's a bug on certain mobile devices. The Discord link still is working. It just will say expired sometimes for some people, but then like others will still be able to use it. It's a strange bug. All right, later, Gavin. Yeah, Revive. So basically what that is YouTube has added gifted memberships. And so anytime that you guys join the stream for the first time, it'll ask you if you want to receive gifts. And that just makes it so that if somebody gifts subs to the channel, you have the possibility of receiving one of those gifted subs. It's a really cool thing. I love that they have finally added gifted subs to YouTube, and it's kind of cool that you can opt in or out to receiving them if for some reason you don't want to get them. Yeah, that would be cool, Simpin. That would be cool. Oh, definitely, Johnny. Definitely. I say regardless of if you get the thing that you were initially grinding for, as long as you got some good stuff along the way, that makes it worth it. Where's the best place for Whitetail? What map? Which map are you looking to know about? Any differences in Great One Red Deer? Do you mean like the way they look? There's a couple differences. There's two different racks for them. I prefer the small rack for them. Yeah, Revive, it doesn't allow me to. Like, for some reason, I'm not able to. It's strange, like, I became a member on my own channel to see if I could gift memberships as, like, giveaways, but it won't let me. I don't even get the option to. Been considering streaming this game. How do you know when you're ready to start being a streamer? Any tips? I mean, I would definitely research it first, like, something that's very beneficial when it comes to starting on a channel is doing your research before you start. So search it up on YouTube, and I typically would type in like whatever the year is and like how to grow a YouTube channel in, well, 2022. That's what I did when I first started. Holy Donald, thank you for the 5 gifted memberships. Well, speaking of the gifted memberships, guys, that's how it works right there. So, congrats to Atomic Acid, Smash, Taylor, Bird Dog, and Lil Mullet Man. You guys have all received a gifted sub from Donald Jewel. Be sure to give them thanks for that. Thank you so much, Donald. That is amazing. Really appreciate that. That is super awesome. Smash is finally a member. That is amazing. That's really cool the way that it works. I think they've done a decent job with it. I think YouTube has done decent with the memberships. I think that's a cool way that it's done. Yeah, if you guys haven't already, be sure to turn on the gifts. Be sure to turn on the ability to receive gifted subs. If I'm not mistaken, you can click on the like little gifted sub icon in the top of the chat. And from there, it should give you the option to enable receiving gifts. It is completely random, though, so that's one thing to keep in mind. It is completely random where the gifts are distributed. Tin Man, thank you so much for renewing your membership for 5 months in a row, dude. Welcome back. All right, let's shoot right here to try and alert these guys. But thank you once again, Donald. That's very generous of you. Very generous. Where's the big males? They're not here. That's for sure. Come on, big males. We need a great one. We need the great one to show. But it looks like there's nothing good here. This lake's been kind of dead the last few runs. Gifted memberships last for 1 month. So for 1 month, anybody that received a gifted membership will have the ability to use all of the emotes in chat, as well as the ability to watch some of the members-only videos I have on the channel. I think there's like 4 or 5 members-only videos that you guys are able to view once you get a membership. I would definitely recommend watching those before the memberships run out. But thank you once again. That's very generous. Yeah, it is random. It is random revive. It's been pretty good, Commander. It's been pretty good. We got a diamond to start the day off today. First thing we shot was a diamond black bear. And then since then, we've had lots of mythicals. I believe so, Thomas. I think so. It would make sense, because I believe every name that I saw pop up that received one was somebody that's here all the time. That's pretty cool. I like the way they've done it. Yeah, it's tier 2s. They changed it from what we had initially heard, Kyla. If I'm not mistaken, I think we were talking about this a couple weeks ago, right? Saying that it was the lowest tier. It turns out it's not actually the lowest tier. It's your second tier that it will default to. I believe it's always the second tier. Or maybe it's the highest tier that's under $5 or something like that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Donald, another 5 gifted. That is just ridiculously generous. Thank you so much, man. And Johnny got one. Nice. Okay, so congrats to Johnny, Ryder, Samuel, Mr. Catfish, and Mark Sells. You guys now have a 1 month membership to the channel. Congrats. Enjoy all the awesome emotes and everything. Thank you so much once again. That is amazing. The entire chat's going to be green names now. Oh man, I think it definitely does choose people that have been here quite a lot. I think it's got to choose people that are here all the time, because every name that I've seen pop up has been a name that I see in the chat all the time. Donald, thank you for a super chat as well. My gosh. I just don't know what to say to this insane amount of generosity and kindness. Like, oh my gosh, man. We must expand the crew at all costs. Indeed, man, indeed. That is crazy. Thank you so much for the super chat and the 10 gifted subs. That's very nice of you. And you made 10 people's days as well. That is awesome. Connor, thank you for the super chat, dude. Really appreciate it. How long are you gonna stream for? Probably another 30 minutes at least. I want to do at least one more black bear run. I'm like really wanting to just get this grind over with. So trying to take out as many bears as I can today during this stream. And because of that, the stream's been going a little longer than what I typically do. What do we need to shoot? That guy. Switch to the other gun. That's a nice 7 there. Hey. I saw another right there. Okay, that one's dead. We didn't get all of them, I don't think. We got most of them, though. Is brown hybrid rare for geese? No, it's not. Hey, King Potato, how's it going? Donald is the great one of the channel. For sure, Tian. For sure. Alright, here we go. Is there going to be any big males running through here? Yes, there is. Haha. Not going to get away from me, buddy. I know, Catfish. That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Oh, and also, Donald, if you are in my Discord, send me a message. That way I can see what your Discord name is, and I'll give you the legendary supporter rank. If you would like that. How do you gift? So the way that you gift is you should be able to find it the same place that you would find Super Chats. But instead of clicking Super Chat, there should be a thing that says gifted memberships. But it'll be in that same menu as the Super Chats. Connor, thank you so much for the Super Chat, dude. Much appreciated. Out of curiosity, if you feel like answering, how much do you make a month out of your full-time YouTube? I don't really reveal the exact, like, numbers. But it's enough to support myself and my family and, you know, pay the bills. And have a little bit back to put in the savings account. But I don't really give out the exact numbers. But I appreciate the support, dude. That's very generous of you. Watch almost all of the streams. Nice, Connor. Nice. Oh, dude. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh gosh. I'm gonna have to scroll up and read through everything. My gosh, Donald. Are you kidding me? are you absolutely kidding me right now? Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. And enjoy the gifted memberships. Cian, C-Mac, Connor Marshall, Tian Van Tonder, Blakester, Chase and Tail, Kim Schnack, Tian, or wait, I already read that, Thomas Lynch, Lamian Dillard, and Nolan Carpenter. Congrats, guys. Congrats. My gosh. That is insane. And Donald with another super chat as well. Oh my gosh. Right back at you, Donald. Right back at you. That's incredibly generous of you. I don't know how to react. Like, you've broken the crow. The crow is now, now broken. I don't know what to say. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Kevin, thank you for the super chat as well. Much appreciated. Can't wait for you to find the great one, Black Bear. Hopefully it's soon, man. Hopefully it's soon. We're hoping today. Maybe we'll get lucky and we'll get a last second great one. But again, thank you guys so much for the insane support. And we've now got 20 brand new members to the channel. That is amazing. That is absolutely amazing. Also, I feel like the member count up there is not correct, because it definitely... We're definitely not at 192. We've definitely broke 200 members. I feel like the Streamlabs is not accurate. That is just... That's crazy. There we go. We got that one down. Connor, thank you so much for another super chat. Really appreciate it. How much for you to stream another hour? Well, you don't gotta pay me to stream another hour, Connor. I was probably gonna stream for another 30 to 60 minutes anyway. But thank you, dude. I really appreciate that. So if we break him more, does it unbreak him? I don't know, Hollow. Maybe. It's possible. Hey, Xyphon. You missed a diamond and a million different gifted memberships going through. Oh, I saw brown on that and I was like, is that a rare bear? Nope, it's a Merriam turkey. Got my hopes up for a second. How do you use the emotes? So there should be like the little emoji button down in the bottom left of the chat. And when you click on that, it'll bring up all of the channel emotes. And that's where you'll be able to use them. The super goat, great one of the channel. Definitely, Tien. Definitely. I'm... I don't know what to say. Bro.exe has stopped working. What do we even do? What was I even gonna do? Where do we usually have males? Yeah, Johnny, now you can use the actual hype emote. I guess we'll go here. My gosh. Yes, that was the first gifted subs. He gifted 20 of them as well. That is just insane. That is just insane. Is brown a rare fur type for bear? It is, Skull Slayer. It is a rare for them. Connor, thank you for another super chat, dude. Really appreciate it. Marine Corps is pretty depressing, but your lives make it so much better. Watch them every day when you stream. Keep it up. Thank you, Semper Fi. Hey, no problem, man. And thank you for your service. For real. Like, I'm happy that the streams help you out. It's a depression's not a fun thing. I've had my little bouts of it occasionally throughout my life, and you're not alone, man. You're not alone, and the streams will always be here. You can always hang out here anytime. Oh my gosh, there it is. It updated. We're at 202 members. We did it, guys. We hit 200 members before the end of the month. We just said that at the beginning of the stream, that it would be cool if we hit 200 by the end of the month, and we hit it in one stream. My gosh, that's crazy. I know, Hollow. Me too. It's awesome to see Johnny with a membership. Also, my voice is absolutely dying. I should probably drink some water. Holy. Well, let me make sure I didn't miss anything. Okay, I don't think I missed anything. I think we're good. But once again, thank you to Donald and Connor. You guys are very generous. I very much appreciate the support. Without people like you, I would not be able to do this full time. And I'm very, very... What's the word? I guess like... Gosh, I'm completely broken. I can't even speak properly. I'm very appreciative and very humbled by the amount of love and support that I've received through doing content here on YouTube, and it really is just something I had always dreamed of being able to do, and the fact that it is something that I'm able to do for a living now is just unbelievable to me, and it's all because of people like you that watch and support the streams and watch the videos. Thank you all. Your next stream after Monday, there will be a surprise? Oh, really, Kevin? Is it gonna be a great one? Hillbilly Rocks, thank you for the super sticker, dude. Really appreciate it. Thank you so much, man. Really appreciate the support. Is a piebald mallard rare? It's not a rare, unfortunately. Rick and Morty's forgotten words. If he can't make words, he can't make terrible jokes. Wow, Hollow. I see how it is now. You got an evil plan to get rid of the dad jokes. It's unbearable to see how much you hate my bear jokes. It'll tell you in chat, Hunter. I almost him, Levi, like... For a second there, I was getting a little choked up. That's why I was getting a little bit hard to speak. How do you gift subs? So the way that you gift them, Braxton, is... There should be an icon, like, bottom right on mobile, and I believe it's like... bottom left on PC. It'll have the little like dollar sign. It's the same place that you send super chats and stuff like that. There should be a gifted membership option there. It's really cool that YouTube decided to do that. Jumpstar came back. Have I missed anything else? No, you have not missed anything else yet. You have not missed any diamonds or rares. The one that we got at the beginning is the only one that we found so far today. But maybe the great one's close. I hope it is. Really hoping to see a great one soon. That's a female bear. Let's see. Braxton, thank you for the 6 months as a member. Really appreciate it, dude. Welcome back. That's crazy. It's already been 6 months. I swear you just became a member recently. Like, that's crazy. It's been 6 months. Time flies, man. Time really flies. Hey, Craven, how's it going, man? Do you know how I can get faster respawns? So you're always getting respawns. The thing is, like, a lot of them will end up going to different areas. So most likely you've already had your respawns, but they're in places that you normally don't look. Yeah, Catfish, unfortunately, it is kind of difficult to do that with lower speed internet. Definitely is more difficult. How to become a member? Well, there's two ways to become a member, either by being gifted one or by clicking the blue join button, and then you can select the tier from there. If you can't see the join button, there's also a link in the description because some iOS devices don't allow it. Michael, thank you so much for becoming a member, dude. Really appreciate it. Welcome to the Scarecrew. Enjoy the green name in chat, special badge icon, all the SM emotes, ability to use commands, access to private Discord channels once you link to YouTube to Discord, and access to my scrap content on the channel. Really appreciate the support, man. Really appreciate it. Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Well, that's another thing that I should probably mention since we had more members, since I mentioned it last. If you guys were gifted a membership, be sure to check out the members-only videos on the channel. I think I've got like 3 or 4 of them. There's a couple of the Hunter Classic videos. I think there's a Call of the Wild video there as well. And also be sure to join the Discord and link your YouTube to Discord in the Discord settings. That way you can get access to the member-only channels. FSU Craven, thank you so much for the 5 months as well. Welcome back, man. You guys are just being so incredibly generous today. I don't even know. I don't know what I did to deserve it, but thank you. This has been an insane day. Like, an absolutely insane day. All we need now to top it off is a great one. If we can get a great one today, this will officially be one of the most... Holy. My gosh. Connor. Oh my gosh, man. That is insanely generous. Holy. Love how you keep playing the game while reading chats and donations. You saved my life. I was about to end it, but found your stream and channel about a month ago. Kept me occupied from my depression and drinking. This is my best way of thanking you for ending it all. I don't know what to say, Connor. I'm really happy to hear that the channel helped you out quite a bit. That's always one of the most incredible things to me is that I never would have expected the stuff that I do here on the channel to be able to help people out of their tough times. And it's really great to hear that the channel's had that effect on you. Just remember, man, there's always people out there that'll care about you. There's always people that are there for you. And you can always come by the stream anytime. And we'll always be here to chat with you and hang out. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that, man. Just keep your head up. Life's got its ups and downs, but it'll all make sense in the end, you know? And I'm happy that you're here in the stream with us. Thank you so much, dude. That's incredible. That is incredible. And Kane, thank you for the super chat as well, dude. Mine's not right there. Can't find it. That is strange, Kane. I've heard a few people say that they can't see the gifting option. I can't see it myself either. It's kind of strange. Some people are able to see it. Others aren't able to. Crow just blue screened IRL. I did, Hollow. I like froze there for a second. Hail Billy Rocks. Thank you for the super chat as well, dude. My gosh, you guys are going crazy today. I truly just am blown away. I don't know what to say. I was just auto walking into the trees, tabbed out. Oh my gosh. Can a great one only spawn at the lakes you hunt them? No. Technically, they could spawn in other places as well, which is why it's good to check areas you're not grinding occasionally, just to make sure that one hasn't randomly spawned over there. Gosh. Oh, that's a male bear, too. Where did he go? My gosh, man. My voice is disappearing, too. Reed, thank you so much for becoming a member, dude. Welcome to the Scarecrew. Enjoy the green name in chat, special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access to private Discord channels once you link Discord to YouTube, and access to the scrap content on the channel. Really appreciate it. Thank you so much, dude. And Hillbilly Rocks, thank you for another super sticker. My gosh. I mean, at this point, I think you guys have basically summoned a great one. Would not be surprised if the great one runs out in front of us right now. I know, Donde, it would be insane, man. The stream's breaking from all the donations. It is, Anti, it is. My game just started lagging out of nowhere. Man. Crow needs a reboot? I do. I should probably go get something to drink real quick. Like, my throat is, like, absolutely on fire. I should probably go get some water. Connor, thank you for another super chat, dude. Really appreciate it, man. Like I was saying, we're always here for you. Just know that no matter what goes on in life, the Scarecrew's always got you. You're always welcome here. You're always welcome in the Discord. Lots of us here are always here to talk and just have fun. The way that bear flopped. That was hilarious. Oh my gosh. Braxton with the 5 gifted. Oh my gosh, man. Braxton. Thank you, man. Dude. And congrats to Riley. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce the Russian characters, but congrats to you too as well. Colton and Donde, welcome, guys. And then who else got one? That was only 4. Who got the 5th one? I don't think it gave out the 5th one. Did it? Did it give it? I think it only gave out 4 of them. Maybe the fifth one is somebody that's not actually in the chat right now, so it didn't pop up. That might be the way it works. I'm actually not sure, but only 4 of them showed up. But thank you so much, Braxton. That's crazy, man. Flanky, thank you for the super chat as well. I don't know what to say at this point. Like, this is just absurd. Dylan, thank you for the 2 months, man. Welcome back. Welcome back to the Scarecrew. And Logan, thank you for becoming a member as well. Enjoy the green name in chat, special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access to private Discord channels once you link YouTube to Discord, and access to my scrapped content on the channel. Much appreciated, man. This is... I think this is officially the most insane stream I think this is the most memberships and donations we've had in a stream in a long time. So thank you, guys. Connor, thank you for another super chat, man. Love your channel. I'm glad you enjoy it, man. I'm glad that you enjoy it. Like I was saying, without people like you supporting the channel, I wouldn't be able to do this as a job, and considering it's my dream job that I wanted to do ever since I was like 14 years old, I really appreciate it. Like, when you're a content creator, it can definitely be difficult to, like, at times it can be difficult to remember, like, the truly important things and the reasons why it's even a thing for me. And I try to always, like, keep myself aware that, you know, without you guys, the channel would be nothing. Without awesome people like you that support the channel and watch all the videos and stuff, the channel would be nothing. So I really am just very appreciative of everything that you guys do to make this what it is. And Cody, thank you so much for a super chat as well, man. Or a super sticker, I mean. That is insane. Thank you so much, man. Gosh, I'm losing my voice even with the water. Oh my gosh. My gosh. Yeah, Tian, this is pretty insane, man. But thank you again, dude. Thank you once again, Cody. Very nice of you. And Hillbilly Rocks, thank you for another super sticker as well. Holy. There's a lot of big males in chat right now. Thank you all so, so much. Yeah, Savage, hopefully we're close, man. Hopefully we're close. Yeah, Logan, this has been insane. Definitely hunting legends, definitely. This has been a ridiculous stream. At this point, I am really just lost for words. Like, I don't know what more I can say to, like, let you guys know how much I appreciate this. This is crazy. Chase and Tail, thank you for the super chat as well, man. Really appreciate it. What is Roosevelt Elk drink time? I'm actually not sure what they changed it to, Yon. Connor, thank you for another super chat. How do I sub so I can talk to the chat? There should be a red subscribe button. There should be a red subscribe button. I think you have to close the chat box in order to reveal the sub button. If you're on mobile, at least, I think you have to close the chat box to see the sub button. And then once you've subscribed, I think after you've been subbed for a minute, then the chat becomes available. If that doesn't work, let me know and I'll try to tweak it a little bit. But I think that should be the way to get it to work. If all else fails, I can always just take it off of sub mode for the rest of the stream. The reason that we've always had sub mode on is because we used to have quite a bit of problems with, like, spam accounts coming in here and dropping just, like, not so appropriate stuff in chat. So we had to put it to sub mode because we would get a lot of spam that would come through, a lot of bots and stuff like that. But yeah, you should be able to chat once you've subscribed. Hey Curly, we did not get it yet, unfortunately. Hopefully we will though. Hopefully the Great One is close. Hopefully it's close. Hey Colton, how's it going? How you doing, man? Alright, let's go to this lake right here. Thinking about changing my grind from bear to red deer? I mean, red deer's definitely a more enjoyable grind, I think, midway. I don't think there's any age limit, Auntie. I think it's just a matter of whether or not you have the means to do it. Yes, and Aldo, no great one yet, man. It's unfortunate. Hopefully soon. How do I link YouTube to Discord? Okay, so when you go to Discord, you should be able to go into the settings, and then it should be in there somewhere. I think it's in the connections category. Let me look real quick so I can make sure. You click user settings, and then it is in connections. Yeah, it'll be in connections towards the top of Discord. What is the best map for the Black Bear grind? I like Silver Ridge Peaks. I think it's probably the best one. Thank you, Curly. I appreciate that, dude. I really appreciate that, man. We'll get the great one eventually. I'm not too worried about it taking a long time. I fully expect this grind to be kind of a lengthy one. So I'm not too worried about how quickly we get it. It would be nice to get it fast, but it is what it is at the end of the day. Can't speed it up any faster than it already is going, you know. Part of it's just up to luck of the draw. Hoping that we end up getting it. Yeah, Hillbilly, thank you, dude. Again, thank you so much. It's not easy having to go without Starbucks, so I really appreciate that. Hey, Nox, how's it going, dude? Hope you've been doing good. What time do you hunt the geese? You can hunt the geese at pretty much any time. Luckily, they don't really have, like, a time constraint at all. You can hunt them pretty much any time of the day and have good success. Yeah, no problem, Reed. You should be able to see the member channels now. Because once it's linked, YouTube automatically will give you the required rank. And also, for anybody that's new to the Discord, be sure to accept your roles, because if you don't accept the roles, then you won't be able to see the channels. Don't see anything. Well, there's a female. Okay, so I think I am going to briefly take it off of sub mode to see if Connor was able to find the sub button or not. I'm going to briefly take it off of subscriber only mode. There will still be the 10 second slow mode though to prevent spam. There we go. We're off of sub mode for now. Hey, GNR, we ended up getting a diamond as the first kill of the day today. Oh, little level 4. So this is what I was talking about earlier, guys. Like, some bears don't get to their zone till really late. This guy is just now getting to his zone here, and it's 1943. We started hunting on this time reset at around 1630. So, some of them are very late. That's about 2 hours. Hey, Fusion, how's it going? Hey, Cannibal Barbecue, how's it going, dude? What's the new sub goal I meant? I'm not actually sure. I'm trying to think of, like, what would be the goal that we would go for right now. Or are you talking about a membership goal? We're currently at 56,209 subscribers. I don't actually even know, like, what the goal would be. I don't really set too many goals on, like, sub count. I kind of just let it go to whatever it goes to. Well, thank you, King. I appreciate that. Glad that you've been enjoying your stay here. Okay, all of these have become small males, so that's not going to help us out much. Let's hope this lake's got more. Hey, Carson, no worries. We got a diamond at the beginning of the stream. Another diamond mountain lion. Nice, Sierra. How rare is an albino pronghorn? It's pretty rare, Austin. You don't see too many rare pronghorns at all. Doing all Great One Grinds going Black Bear SRP, Whitetail Ravantuli, Rancho, and Red Deer New Zealand. Nice, dude. Going for all of them at once. I mean, that might be the way to do it, you know? Bound to get one of them. Wild Man, thank you so much for the super chat, dude. And I'm glad that I can be an inspiration to you. Oh, he couldn't, Levi? Well, I turned off sub mode, so you should be able to talk even without being a subscriber now. You should be able to chat even without being a sub. And also, if I'm not mistaken, members can chat even in sub mode, even if they're not subscribed. I think members can still chat. Not sure, Colton. I think we're just going to keep going until I run out of energy. I think we'll just keep going until I can't go no more. Because I do have to get some recording done for tomorrow's video. Oh, that thing died quick. Any giants? That's a good bear. Oh, that poor thing. Oh, that poor bear. Well, we got two. What is the easiest great one to get? I'd say red deer probably. Because Te Awaroa is insane. I'm glad the videos have helped you out, Hunter 11, and I'm sorry to hear that, dude. I've been through that as well, and it's definitely never easy, so I'm glad that this has helped you out. How many black bear have I killed this grind? Probably close to 1,800 now. I'd say probably around there. I haven't kept an exact count, but if I were to give an estimate, it's probably around 1,800. Connor, thank you for becoming a member, dude. Really appreciate it, man. Welcome to the Scarecrow. Enjoy the green name in chat, special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access private Discord channels once you link Discord to YouTube, and access to my scrap content on the channel. You should be able to chat now. Like, it shouldn't have any issues now. There we go. How's it going, man? Glad you were finally able to get into the chat. I turned off the sub mode, so it should have been letting you. I don't know why it wasn't. At least you're able to now, though. At least you're able to now. Not black bear? Definitely, Johnny. Black bear are definitely not the easiest great one. I'd say they're the most difficult, probably. Thank you, Lane. Appreciate it. Oh, no, D's. That's unfortunate, dude. That's sad to hear, man. How to become a member? It should be the big blue join button. Yeah, we got a lot of Connors in here, I notice. I think I've seen like four different Connors in chat. It's a Connor kind of day. Definitely, Donde, definitely. I try to always keep the positive vibes up there. I've always been very big on keeping a positive attitude towards everything. Try to keep everything super positive here in the streams. Because I've always found that negativity doesn't get you anywhere in life. Being negative never gives you anything good in return, you know? If you're positive, It'll breed positivity around you. That's what I've learned. Alright, so, I think we might jump onto Rev on Thule for a little bit. The Great One Black Bear Grind is, starting to get to me. So I think we will jump onto Rev on Thule briefly, because I do want to see if we can quickly find something cool there. We shall see. Let's see if we can find a cool Rev on Thule trophy. Connor, thank you for another super chat, dude. Thank you to everyone that helped me, especially Lucky Bucky. Yeah, I'm glad that we were finally able to get you into the chat, man. That's awesome. And also, once again, thank you for the support. I really appreciate it. It really is a barbecue. It really is. Black bear hunting in Mississippi is super tough. Definitely one of the most difficult places to do it. Davis Pritchard, thank you for becoming a member, dude. Welcome to the Scarecrew. Enjoy the green name in chat, special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access to private Discord channels once you link Discord to YouTube, and access to my scrap content on the channel. Really appreciate it, man. Really appreciate it. Everybody, let's get some hype in chat. Since we got quite a few new members, a lot of you should have access to all the emotes now, so let's get the hype emote in chat. For all of the amazing support that the channel's received in this stream. There we go. I want to see a big green wall of hype emotes. There we go. That is a beautiful sight. That is a beautiful sight. Nice, Carson. That's awesome. Post in the Discord if you are in there. Thank you once again to all of the amazing supporters of the channel. I really appreciate it. Now let's find ourselves a cool trophy. How do you link Discord to YouTube? So when you go into Discord, you click the little like settings cog button in the bottom left. And then should be towards the top of the list. There'll be one that says connections. And that will be how you can link it. And once you've linked it, you will get automatically given the role that opens up the member channels. Where do we want to go? I kind of want to head over to this lake. That's a good moose lake. Oh, you changed your name like 5 times. Okay, that makes sense. I don't know, Braxton. It's really hard to estimate. There's been so much going on, I haven't even been able to, like, fully take in everything that's happened. Alright, later, Mason. Thanks for dropping by, man. Not IRL, Andy. We live pretty far away from each other, but I chat with him now and then. That's awesome to hear, Norwegian Hunter. I'm happy that I can make your days better. I mean, you guys make my days better just by being here and hanging out with me in these streams. That's the big reason why I enjoy doing live streams more than videos. Because with a video, I don't get that live interaction with you guys in the chat. I love making videos, but there's just something about live streams that are... they're more exciting and more enjoyable because I can chat with you guys while I'm playing. I see shadows. Canada Goose, okay. I just remembered I don't have anything to shoot lynx with. And I only have a 22 for birds. I should probably change my loadout. That might be good. You have any rares in Revontuli? I'm trying to remember. Have I got any rares? I got the Melanistic Lynx. I think that's about it. Well, I did get a piebald female moose as well. So piebald moose and Melanistic Lynx are the only rares I've got since the full release of Revontuli. In early access, I had a few rares for the waterfowl, but not been able to get any since then. 22 will be fine. I hope so. Let's just hope we don't have to shoot a bunch of ptarmigan. Otherwise, it might be a problem. It can be pretty random, Squizzy. Sometimes it really is just up to random chance and luck and hoping that you get something good to spawn. Some people's luck is just unfortunately not as good as others. Random moose on top of the mountain. Interesting. That's an interesting place to see some moose. Yeah, Chris, she does. Yeah, King, it does. There is a ton of different species on Revontuli. A total of 19. 19 species are on Revontuli Coast. The most of any Call of the Wild map. It's kind of crazy. Yes, Carson. Members can use commands. I've done collabs with Flinter Logan. I have 2 videos on the channel with him, and then I've got like 3 or 4 live streams with him as well. There's one on him too, or on one on his too. No, Carter, this isn't pre-recorded. Live streams are never pre-recorded. That's why they're live streams. What are commands? Just like what Crazy Honk did. Oh, that's unfortunate, Tien. It's probably on your end, I would say. Because it looks fine to me. Yeah, we did get the albino lynx, but that was in early access. So I'm not really going to count the early access trophies as getting rares. Because we didn't get to keep them this time around. They didn't carry over. So, as of now, it's just the moose and the melanistic lynx. The only rares we've got of Revontuli so far. Hopefully we can get some soon. We've got a few diamonds, like we got the capercaillie, we got the black grouse. I think we got a capercaillie, at least. I know for a fact we got a black grouse. And then we got the willow ptarmigan. I don't know if we've had any other diamonds, though. I really need to get out on Revontuli and try to get some of the waterfowl diamonds, but this black bear grind has just consumed all of my time. Oh, wow, Chase and Tail. That's unlucky, dude. That's really unlucky. 191's really big, Logan. Have you done other collabs with other content creators? I have done stuff with Kill Clinton, Flinter. I did a video with DD33 and a couple streams with Lady Legend. And then I did a Phasmophobia stream with Mel's Gaming. So yeah, I've collabed with quite a few of the content creators in the Call of the Wild community. I don't really do a lot of collabs unless it's somebody that I feel I get along with really well, though. Like, I'll only do collaborations if the other content creator kind of matches my style. Like, that's why I do a lot of stuff with Kill Clinton and Flinter, because I feel like I get along with them a lot better than I do most people. Because we have similarities. We like the same stuff. We have a lot in common. So I try to keep the collabs to people that I have good, like, what's the word? Is it like synergy? Good synergy with, where like we can just chat all day about whatever. Oh, that's right. I've been streaming longer than normal, so yeah, today's video just went live. In that case, I should probably end the stream. But this was quite an amazing stream, guys. And once again, thank you all so much. Connor, thank you for another super chat. Really appreciate it, man. Hope the fam's doing well. If you need anything, let me know. All right, man, for sure. I mean, you've already done so much with all of these insane super chats and stuff. I really appreciate it, Connor. Like, you have no idea, like, how much it means to me. So thank you so much. And once again, I'm super happy that the channel's been able to help you. Be sure to talk in the Discord if you're in there. That's what the member channels are for. So if you want to, you can always chat in there. Lots of people to chat to. I pop in there from time to time as well. But thank you so much for the support. Really generous. But I'm going to go ahead and leave you guys with the video for today. So we're going to go ahead and jump off. We'll be streaming tomorrow again, though. Same time as always. But for now, enjoy today's upload. It just went live. And thank you all for the support once again. Truly incredible and truly just so thankful for all of you. But I will see you all in the next one. Peace. Oh, and also, yes, the family's been doing very good, Connor. I almost forgot to answer that part. Yes, the family's been doing very good. We have been doing very, very well. Aaliyah is, she's becoming quite the character. The older she gets, the more amazing it is. Like, it's truly crazy seeing the changes from even just a couple months ago. But yeah, thank you guys for being here. And I will see you all.